Hello, Kent Weakley here with another photography tip. Today we've got a little bit of a controversial issue. To UV or not to UV? What we're talking about here is putting a UV filter over the end of our lens. Now, these get sold two different ways. They tell us that number one, it's going to reduce ultraviolet light, and number two, it's going to protect your lens. Well, let's take a look at this. This lens is not cheap. Most of the lenses aren't cheap, and they're made very well. They've got great optics in them. Some of these have dozens of different pieces of glass doing various things that are making your images look great. I got to tell you, I don't use UV filters, and one of the reasons why is I can't justify putting this $20 or $30. Actually, I saw some that are getting crazy online just recently. They're like $70 or $80. I can't justify putting this little piece of glass on top of all these great optics and potentially taking away some of the benefit that I've purchased in this lens. The second thing that they tell you is that it's going to protect it. Well, guess what? I use my lens hood for that. My lens hood is going to protect the front element of my lens more than a little piece of glass sitting on there. Besides, this is going to get touched just as much without a lens hood, and you're going to have to clean it just as much. So I use my lens hood. If you want to learn more about using your lens hood and utilizing it, I have another blog post on that. Go back to my blog and check it out. The other thing with the UV filter is reducing UV light. It's so minimal, it's almost not even visible, and quite honestly, it's a quick little level adjustment in either a Photoshop or Photoshop Elements or in Lightroom that can take that little bit of haze out, and you can fix that very quickly. So for me, I can't justify it. It's too expensive, and these get sold after the fact too. You buy a camera, you buy a lens, you buy a body, and they're pushing all these extra sales. They're pushing the memory cards, the extra batteries, and all that sort of stuff. They're almost always pushing these as well. Not to say that's a bad thing. It's your choice. You have to decide. So UV filter, do you use them or not? Leave a comment. I'd be interested to find out. If you'd like to find out more tips like this and keep learning more down the road, be sure to subscribe to my blog. Go in the top right corner, click on the word subscribe, and you're set. Thanks. Take care.